everybody had no idea why. Had absolutely no idea why. And FRE, when he asked Darren this morning, Darren basically just said, I don't know.
Fire and wire, but I constructed a pretty decent
guy.
He would think with all that water under his feet, he'd have some kind of an antenna system. Him being the kind
of engineer. He's just a phony, that's all he is.
Last time I knew that he actually constructed and engineered an antenna, he had it up for about an hour and a half, but he came out and he says, well, it was working, but it fell down.
Hi. You're not familiar with, he's a CB-er with a ham ticket. He's not an amateur radio licensee. He doesn't know CW, he doesn't even know Ohm's Law. He had no idea.
It lasted him about an hour and a half.
FRE just fried him, but it was a very subtle fry.
He went back to
the first one. He was Darren. That's because Darren had no idea. He was saying, oh yeah, you got to do this. And he was like, oh, you have to do this.
I forgot what day it was, it was a couple, three, 4 years ago, and he was out there bragging to a guy, man, that he was a professional DJ.
He had no idea. I mean, these guys are just little amateur radio talent.
Can you imagine being a DJ?
Well, I don't know. They have no idea what's going on. W-O-N-I-E is a phony. He tries to pretend.
He went to a lot of interesting people there being a professional DJ.
Oh, this is the flat earth guys.
You gotta know CW, you gotta know the basic electronics.
Brain surgery.
Almost sounded like he was gonna cry today too. He was.
Oh yeah.
He said that, you know, all of his family's all out working and he's just sitting there on his dumb ass doing nothing. That's because he has no skills. He has no skills to pay the bills. How he's living and he's having to throw away all his junk because he's got to squeeze it into 600 square feet. How the hell are you going to do that? Throw away all your junk. In about a year, you're going to be saying, well, I wish I wouldn't have thrown that away.
Radio World. Joey and Roger.
Yeah, Roger. It would be terrible to wake up every day in a horizontal position, knowing that you just soiled yourself, and it's going to be 3 hours for your caregiver comes. Can you imagine?
That would be terrible. Does that happen to you? I'm in peak health here, Darren. You know I don't take any pharmaceuticals. Don't need any pharmaceuticals. I'm like in some of the best health of my life. I really don't.
Well, he turns over a lot when he's rolling over.
You know, I think that really affects
him. Yeah, there's a quiet moment. There's a little bit of a quiet moment. And he says, all right, I'll see you in about 6 or 7 hours.
That's kind of strange, too, you know. He used to get on other operators for drinking, and now he finds himself drinking. What's up with that? Why are you drinking, Darren? What's going on? I mean, he also says he smokes pot. So I'm not sure if he does that or not, or if he just pretends. He says he smokes pot and he drinks. That's illegal to smoke pot in Indiana. I'm not sure he's telling the truth about that, but I mean, those are not healthy lifestyles.
It's illegal to smoke it. I think possession is how they figure it. I don't think it's illegal to smoke it. It's just the possession. You know, but, you know.
That's
sure sounds differently, so that's what we got to believe.
Well, the thing is, though, how do you smoke it if you don't possess it?
That's like magic.
How do you smoke it if you don't possess it?
Well, you figure that out. Let me know.
What an idiot. You know, I think you need to go down to the hospital and say you're having a mental problem. I'm serious about that. I mean, you're running off the rails. I mean, you stopped going to church?
I don't think he does a little bit. I think he's full-blown.
I mean, you don't go to church anymore. You're admitting to drinking. You're admitting to smoking pot. I mean, this is like a
180-degree opposite of the Darren that we used to hear out here a year ago.
I think he'll be stuck there all the time because he's confused. He knows that what he does is wrong. I mean,
he used to be a religious goer. They kicked him out of the church. He wore this big beard. They said, hit the road. So he left the church. Now he's smoking pot and drinking.
We just said some of the wacky stuff.
The truth. You haven't been listening to 7200. He's been drinking lately.
Well, I listen here and there, Darren. I hear a helicopter landing by your house.
That was not a helicopter. That was, we call them things, a drone. It was a drone.
That was a hard thing to remember.
One gentleman, he actually does his farming with a drone, but this was not the same drone. This was a black drone, and it was at nighttime. They was not spraying. And, anyways, yeah, they were out there. I don't know if they were doing practice test runs over on the other side of 64 or not, you know, and then flying it and just seeing if they could do it remotely. And but they did it for about 3 days, and then that was it. I never seen them again.
Darren, your lifestyle has radically changed in the last year. You used to go to church sometimes 2 or 3 times a week, no drinking, no pot smoking, and now all of that has reversed. What the heck is going on?
Spraying with a drone, though. I mean, I don't see how that was more efficient than going out there with a tractor. Other than they just added a tax deduction and a new hobby.
Oh, yeah, they could have been testing, or they could be looking for certain infestation and spreading the rest of the
pond. I don't know, but they did. They did that for 2 days. Like I said, the drone that we seen tonight was a totally different drone. It was jet black. I think it was, maybe the state police, they come down here all the time, and they do a lot of training and search and rescue because people get lost in the forest.
Well, I know a couple of years ago, the local police department here got a drone for a couple summers. You would hear that thing go cruising on the street. It's pretty good size and kind of got its own sound.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I think it had 4 great big propellers on it.
Now, those get into some money,
Oh, yeah, I bet it was. Like I said, that one was carrying a tank and it was spraying. I mean, they'd spray for about 10, 15 minutes, and then they'd come in, land, fill back up, and go out again.
Yeah, well, that's got a tank on it. That sounds fairly
industrial,
but, yeah, that's
going to
have a pilot on the other end.
Yeah, there was a guy on a remote. He was in the field. Doing it, standing on the edge. But the one at night, it was a different drone. It was totally a different drone. Like I said, it might have been state police or the local sheriff's department or EMA doing a search and rescue practice. Who knows what they were doing?
Yeah, what is it? I think now it could go over, like a half pound or like 450 grams or something.
Well, the bad thing is, out there in the woods like that, you got a lot of people that coon hunt and this and that. You know, they're lucky they can get that shot down. That could cost somebody a bunch of money.
Their kids now. Their kids will be out there working with them.
and they'll charge. You know, I think when those boys turn 16 years old, they're working and they're making paychecks, so they got to give all that money that they make to their mom and dad until they become 18 or move out of the house.
Yeah, come on there, mama.
Make
three more.
That's right. Yeah, so that's the reason why daddy has so much, but, you know, they're pretty good at hiding it. Trust me, they like cash and carry. I don't know what they're going to do when FedNow takes over and goes everything digital. They'll be screwed.
Yeah, that'd
be like the marking system.
They'll have to go to a little tiny gold stamp office.
I don't know what they're going to do. But they're worried about it because it's been brought up. I've talked to them about it, and they're really, really concerned about what they need to do.
Yeah, they'll have to print a little, 30 seconds of a gram and 16ths of a gram and an eighth of a gram and a quarter gram. And, you'll have to print a little golden stamp, and it'll be like tamper-proof where if you scratch on it, it'll rip it or whatever. But yeah, they're going to have to break the gold that there is. They're going to have to break it down in little teeny, itty bitty amounts.
Well, one thing we can say about people is people will like to try to exploit people. And so I'm sure that them being the masters of barter, they'll figure something out.
Paper out and have all the gold come back. And so they don't want to take all that hard earned gold and break it down and distribute it, you know, Darren. They want to hang on to it.
Right. We got a break out there?
Yeah, sorry about that.
That's all right. We might have done it together. I think he was making a comment about us that we doubled back at one time. Have you noticed that if you just ignore and just go on with Q so it leaves?
Roger, roger.
But anyway, yeah, that was something they're really worried about it. They said, we don't know what we're going to do. I said, well, you're not going to be the only ones in that situation. Anybody that's a good red-blooded American Christian is going to face the same obstacle. W-O-N-E.